candidates as far as I'm concerned. And right now, LeBron is just putting on a show. It's something special to behold, y'all. It really, really is. It's the reason why Kobe Bryant was there with his daughter yesterday watching that game, because LeBron James is putting on a show. So we'll see if that continues. Looking forward to the Clippers-Houston Rockets this Friday night, by the way. Doc Rivers and the Clippers swear you'll see a different team because they'll have the entire team intact. Paul George and Kawhi Leonard will not be experiencing load management of any variety. I believe they will be in the lineup Friday night, ready to avenge their loss to Houston last week in Houston, Texas, which I did attend, and I did my show, Sports Center with Stephen A. Smith, on Wednesday nights. Whenever there's a 7:30 game on ESPN, I'm on from 7 to 7:30 a.m., p.m., rather. I did a show from there last week. Now let me get back to Colin Kaepernick. There are going to be people out there who believe that I'm vilifying him. I'm doing no such thing. I still support Colin Kaepernick getting back into the league. I still support the fact that he should have never been exiled from the league. What I'm abhorring, and I'm disgusted by, was his no-show to the workout on Saturday. You simply don't get to do what you want to do, how you want to do it, when you want to do it, while you're asking for somebody else's job. It's the wrong message to send to people, because that's fool's gold. It doesn't work that way. It doesn't work that way. And it's time that people recognize that, particularly at a time when it's at your disadvantage. Understand the excellence of the black quarterbacks we're seeing in football today. Deshaun Watson, Lamar Jackson, Patrick Mahomes, Russell Wilson. With Russell Wilson being the highest paid player in the NFL, does not exactly put Colin Kaepernick in a position that squeezes the NFL out of their comfort zone. Nobody was thinking about Colin Kaepernick before the league announced that they were going to conduct this workout this past Saturday, last Tuesday. Nobody was thinking about him. He had faded from the headlines. Nobody was thinking about it. And for them to organize a workout and for 25 different teams to show up and he elect not to do so, hiding behind some liability waiver, is a problem. Now, I understand he might be averse to, oh, wait a minute, I don't have the right to sue you. I've signed contracts like that. Matter of fact, when I go to the doctor's office, I got to sign that all the time. In the event that something goes wrong with this surgical procedure, you don't have the right to sue us. Employment contracts. Happens all the time. Why are we acting like we don't know this? So, I am abhorring the fact that he didn't show up to the workout. I'm not castigating him. I'm not character assassinating him. I personally think he's getting bad advice. But there's a reason that when I saw him, I shook his hand. I said, I hope you well. Because I'm rooting for him, brother. I'm not rooting against him, but I think it was a bad decision not to show up for a workout. It was a job interview. You didn't show up for it, but you're talking about how you deserve the job. It doesn't work that way. Regardless of how wrong it is, it doesn't work that way. And to disseminate the kind of message that would say it should or it will is stupid, because it's not going to happen. That's my issue with Colin Kaepernick this Saturday. That's it. Nothing else. Anybody that wants to talk to me, anybody that wants to listen to me, understand that. He's been blackballed. It was unfair. And I'm down for his cause. How he has handled it is my issue. Eric Reed is an entirely different brand. This dude is out of control.
You use the latest technology.
And I'm not going to go back and forth on social media any longer. I had some time over the weekend. He came at me. I addressed him. I'm not going to waste my time too much on that. But I will not back up.
This is the Nest Wi-Fi from Google. It has a router that connects your fast and strong network.
Columnists and others who think you have a right to ingratiate yourself into this beef, you got another thing coming. I'm going to say exactly what I said to Max Kellerman this morning. If you're white, you know what you are? You're a spectator of racism. You're not victimized by it. You're not a participant. Fall the hell back and mind your business. This has nothing to do with you. As it pertains to me and Eric Reed, I'm talking about. This is about this man feeling the need to call out other people's blackness because they don't agree with his methodology. He has acted like a juvenile and a child, and on occasions like a bully. But where's your bully pulpit? Microphone that I'll provide it to you. Matter of fact, one could make the argument if it wasn't for this issue with Colin Kaepernick, you wouldn't even know Eric Reed existed. What has he done to create headlines other than bowing and articulating and verbalizing his support of Colin Kaepernick? He's a third leading tackle on the Carolina Panthers. So, they're an average team. Because I think he's a good player. And Eric Reed also took a knee for us. So guess what? I got respect for that brother. What I don't respect is what he's been doing when it comes to Colin Kaepernick in terms of trying to define and highlight folks' blackness or lack thereof. Who the hell are you? Who the hell are you? Especially when you're collecting a check from him.
Everybody on the floor just pause. Somebody in the middle just move. Get on down to the room. Give me the track.
People want to come at me on social media. How come y'all ain't coming to ask him that question?
Give me the track.
I ain't perfect. And no matter what we do, there's always more we could do. I do recall, however, I just generated over $4 million in scholarship for African Americans. My contribution to my alma mater and other charitable foundations were noted.
Get on down to the room.
My contribution to my family is well noted. And oh, by the way, I'm not sending younger black children down a path of destruction by giving them the wrong kind of advice that leads nowhere, because I'm caught up in my feelings. That would be Eric Reed. I was on the Steve Harvey morning show today. I don't have time to talk to everybody. I don't have time to be interviewed by everybody. But the Eric Reeds of the world, the Colin Kaepernicks of the world, the people that want to talk, hey, we can get through. Surrounded by black people across this nation. Let Eric Reed and Colin Kaepernick show up. Let them challenge me to show up. Name the time and place. I'll be there. Ain't nobody hiding. How y'all think this is? Y'all forgot who the hell I am? Ain't nobody backing up. I want Colin Kaepernick back in the NFL. But this Saturday was not the way to go about it. Dr. Michael Eric Dyson came on First Take this morning and articulated an eloquent thought from an historical perspective about Martin Luther King, about Malcolm X, about things that were planned and executed. And how dealing with things haphazardly has never worked to the advantage of African Americans in this nation's history. Everybody's talking about how the younger folks are always running, spearheading movements and what have you. Guess what? Those were brilliant young folks that didn't just act impetuously and belligerent. There's no regard. But it was his partnership at the table that got 25 teams to show up to give Colin Kaepernick a workout. I was told Colin Kaepernick has showed up, he would have had a job for 2 months. I was also told one of the leading candidates to grab him were the Atlanta the case. They're pushing on.